When you upload your information into GEDmatch, do you realize that you're uploading your sisters, your parents, your potential grandchildren's genetic information into this system?
DNA registries are the newest tool for investigators.
The match investigators were looking for had to wait for a more modern database to emerge.
Authorities saying they found a match for DNA collected at the crime scene on a genealogy website.
Thanks to a genetic genealogy site called GEDmatch, detectives were able to match the suspect's DNA.
In reality, DNA is going to be everywhere. It's going to be on your cell phone. It's going to be on the objects that you touch on a regular basis. You pick up a knife, you pick up scissors, you touch a door handle. Your DNA is going to get transferred onto every surface that you make contact with. But a DNA profile for forensics is only valuable when you can compare it to something else. From a DNA sample, there are so many different avenues that you can take. You can do traditional DNA typing in order to make inclusions and exclusions about the evidence. But then you can also explore phenotyping, which is looking at the hair color, the eye color, the skin pigmentation of an individual, and ancestry informative markers, which are allowing you to gain information about where a person might have come from. So if an individual has a particular allele or single nucleotide polymorphism at one particular location in the DNA, it could mean that they likely originate from one particular part of the world because that variation or that polymorphism is only seen in that part of the world. In the context of cold cases, missing persons, and unidentified human remains, phenotyping and ancestry become extremely powerful. There was a case on the west coast of Canada involving a young girl who was murdered, Marissa Shen, and they didn't really have any investigative leads or information about the suspect from the DNA profiles that they generated. So they then took that DNA and performed phenotyping and ancestry testing in order to gain inferences about the suspect. So they were then able to build a composite profile about where that suspect likely came from and what that suspect potentially could have looked like in order to take the investigation in a new direction. GEDmatch is a free public database. And how GEDmatch works is individuals who participate in programs like 23andMe, Ancestry.com, MyHeritage, etc., download their individual profiles from the paid programs that they participated in, and then upload independently their profiles into GEDmatch. The more you are related to somebody, the more similar your DNA will be. And so GEDmatch takes all of that genetic data that you've put into the system and then starts matching it and giving you a number as to how much of your chromosomal DNA matches somebody else. So how investigators are able to really take advantage of this new genetic genealogy era, they essentially just mimic how these companies have designed their DNA kits. And so they take the crime scene evidence and they run it through this new DNA kit that gives a DNA profile or a genetic output that is very similar to these big companies. And from there, they can upload it into the public database in order to see if there are any potential relatives or any potential matches. For example, the Golden State Killer, they uploaded the crime scene samples of the suspect and they searched GEDmatch and they found that there was an individual in the database who shared a large amount of genetic information. And then they then were able to narrow down their suspect pool looking at who that individual was. And they did that using genealogy records because all of this stems from genealogy and looking at marriage records and familial trees. When they were able to get an inference as to who the suspect may be, they then followed him and collected evidence that he freely discarded. And then they compared that DNA evidence that they collected to the crime scene samples that they had in the lab. People are choosing to put their genetic data out there for comparisons to be made. The investigators are utilizing kind of like the Facebook of genetic databases. People are freely providing this genetic information, and it's just becoming another investigative tool. That public database will only be as useful as we allow it to be because we are the ones contributing the information. One really interesting thing about the Golden State Killer case, after the Golden State Killer was apprehended using this freely available public database, there was actually an increase in the amount of profiles uploaded into the database. And I think this speaks to people's innate desire to help or to want to contribute to a better society, to the greater good.